Rhys shines for Derbyshire. It was all to play for at the county ground as Gloucestershire sat just one spot behind Derbyshire in the Division 2 table. The hosts would be desperate to avoid defeat and the prospect of being leapfrogged by the visitors. Host skipper Godderman was unable to lead by example in the morning session after Miles claimed his wicket for just 8 runs. Rhys seemed to be the man equipped to take on Gloucestershire's bowling attack as he peppered the boundary and built some early runs. The excitement was short-lived though, as Higgins drew an LBW call against Madsen, leaving Derbyshire 75 for 2. An over later, and Rhys brought up his half-century with a crunching 4 off Miles. Derbyshire managed to make it to the break with 92 for 3, an up and down morning for both sides, highlighting why they are so close in the table. Gloucestershire made the more positive start to the afternoon as Higgins bowled lace with Derbyshire just 98 for 4. Critchley and Hughes were able to steady the host's innings as the afternoon progressed. Critchley though eventually departed after sending a Miles delivery into the air and the grateful grasp of Howell at 149 for 5. The wicket signalled a shift in momentum as Miles quickly accounted for the wicket of Hughes with an LBW call. Hosin suffered the same fate moments later, LBW this time following a Taylor delivery, Derbyshire 170 for 7 after a flurry of wickets. Two balls later and Vilhune followed Hosin's lead, bowled LBW by Taylor. Two overs later and Palladino became Taylor's third victim, bowled with the hosts 184 for 9. 184 for 9 became 184 all out, as a Miles delivery to Dal was sent through the air for a Taylor catch. The end of the innings brought about the tea break, with Gloucestershire taking the advantage into the final session of the day. The visitors' reply was dealt a blow when opener Hammond struggled to 4 before being bowled by Palladino, the Derbyshire man claiming his 50th wicket of the season. Dent and Bracey were able to regroup after the early shock and slowly build the Gloucestershire innings once again. It didn't last too long as Rhys trapped Bracey LBW to leave the visitors 75 for 2. Two overs later and Howell became Rhys's second victim, LBW the method of dismissal once again. The Gloucestershire batsmen clearly weren't paying attention as Rhys's next spell saw another LBW shout, this time against Charlesworth. Skipper Dent couldn't be blamed for a sense of deja vu as he watched all his partners depart in the same manner. However, it gave him no excuse as he inexplicably became Rhys's fourth wicket, the spell of LBW calls leaving the visitors 100 for 5. Stumps were called at Derby not long after, with Drizzle and Taylor the duo fresh at the crease. Gloucestershire's first innings had been left in disarray by a Rhys bowling spell, with both sides still evenly matched after a day's play. Gloucestershire eye 150 for victory at Derby. Day one belonged to the bowlers, Craig Miles with 5 for 50, helping Gloucestershire restrict Derbyshire to just 184 first innings runs. However, in keeping with the theme of the day, Lewis Rhys managed 4 for 15 to help leave the visitors still 84 runs short of parity with 5 wickets left. Having arrived at the middle late in the day, Drizzle never really got going for Gloucestershire, bowled by Ferguson in the morning for just 6. Matt Taylor looked set to build a partnership with brother Jack, however the latter sent a Rhys delivery behind to Hosin to leave the visitors 135 for 7, Rhys completing his fifer. The tail was starting to crumble as Higgins could only make 12 before a Vilhune delivery was looped into the air and captured by Madsen. Miles was next up and became Rhys's 6th wicket as he edged behind to Hosin with Gloucestershire in trouble at 158 for 9. Rhys's amazing innings ended with his 7th wicket and career best figures of 7 for 20. Taylor caught by Ferguson with the visitors all out for 163. Derbyshire would return for their 2nd innings with a 21 run lead as a cushion. The first over of Derbyshire's innings didn't go to plan as skipper Godderman was trapped LBW by Payne, having made just 4. The hosts avoided any further dismissals to see Rhys and Madsen at the crease at lunch with 21 for 1 on the board. Gloucestershire would still have an uphill battle to get back into the contest, but the wicket before the break provided a glimmer of hope. The visitors claimed quick wickets after lunch. Madsen first trapped LBW by Higgins, followed two overs later by Rees, caught by Hammond off the bowling of Higgins again, leaving Derbyshire 32 for 3. Lace and Hughes managed to stem the flow of wickets for short periods until Lace was trapped LBW by Howe. Critchley, having made 10, was the next Derbyshire wicket to fall, bowled by Drizzle with his side 84 for 5. There was time for one more wicket before tea, as Hosin struggled with a Miles delivery, giving Dent a catch. The break was called with the hosts 97 for 6 and their lead over 100 runs, despite a dreary second innings performance. Derbyshire went past 100 before Dal was caught by Howell off a Higgins ball, the hosts 114 for 7. With the day drawing to a close, Derbyshire's tail was wilting, Vilhjoen caught behind by Bracey off Miles. Miles' next spell with the ball saw Palladino make 2 before an attempt found the hands of Dent. The Derbyshire innings was ended by Taylor as he forced Ferguson to feather behind to Bracey for a duck, the hosts all out for 157. Gloucestershire set a target of 179 for victory. It couldn't have been a worse start for the visitors as Dent was caught behind off a Ferguson delivery with 0 for 1 on the board. Gloucestershire was shaken as Bracey made just 2 before being bowled by Ferguson with the score at 19 for 2. The visitors managed to make it to stumps without any further casualties. Hammond at the crease with night watchman Drizzle 29 for 2 on the board. Gloucestershire needing 150 runs on day 3 to confirm victory. Gloucestershire hold off Derbyshire bowlers to win. A definitive result at the county ground looked likely on day 3 as Gloucestershire arrived knowing that 150 runs with 8 wickets in hand would seal victory. Derbyshire would be hoping that the trend of bowlers coming out on top would continue and give them a fighting chance. Hammond and night watchman Drizzle managed to navigate the early goings-on safely with the occasional boundary. Palladino was the man to end Drizzle's plucky resistance, trapping him LBW to leave Gloucestershire 54 for 3. Heading into the lunch break at 115 for 4. The visitors were 64 runs from victory and Derbyshire needed something special from their bowlers in the afternoon to avoid the inevitable. Howell was looking to help the visitors to their total in double quick time as he sent Palladino to the boundary twice and brought up his 50 from just 49 balls. Critchley managed to split the partnership as his delivery to Howell ended up in a catch for Hughes. Charlesworth seemed to feel the effect of his partner's departure as moments later a Critchley delivery saw him caught on the pads and departing LBW. All of a sudden, the Gloucestershire victory wasn't so clean-cut. Higgins caught and bowled by Ferguson to leave them 158 for 7 and 21 runs away from a win. The visitors were in serious danger of letting victory slip through their fingers as Taylor swiped a Ferguson delivery to Godderman, the score 169 for 8. With their lower order in free fall, it was down to Miles in his final appearance to hit the key boundary to secure victory for Gloucestershire. The late drama seeing Derbyshire lose by 2 wickets after a spirited day 3 display. 3 points for the hosts, the visitors departing with 19.